And hello everyone! Another collection of news and a reason to talk. Today in the video we'll talk about the election of a new president of the Rhythmic Gymnastics Federation, about another gymnast who decided to actively engage in TikTok, about the tournament because of which there was a lot of controversy and which has already started in Minsk, about the first results in the Israeli star. We will discuss the high-profile injuries of the gymnast. And finally we will discuss the topic with Sasha Soldatova, which everyone has been asking for. On December 11th, an election conference will be held in the Russian Gymnastics Federation, at which a new president of the All-Russian Rhythmic Gymnastics Federation will be elected. At the moment, this post has been held since 2008 by Irina Alexandra Viner. According to her, she intends to be re-elected for a new term. But here, in principle, as with the Russian government, surprises should not be expected. Who knows? I think for gymnastics this may not be so bad, since Irina Alexandrovna really does a lot and develops gymnastics not only in Russia but also in the world. But at the same time, it could become an impetus for a new inspiration and a new wave in gymnastics. Right, what do you think about it? Would you like Irina Alexandrovna Viner to leave the presidency and someone would have take her place? A little news from the life of the media related to gymnasts. I have already repeatedly told, and I even had a separate video on the channel, that Vera Birikova is now in the TikTok house and is developing there as a media person. True, her TikTok house has changed its name and now it's called the POPSTAR HOUSE. But what is interesting for us is that now there is not only Vera Birikova, but also another equally famous gymnast, Julia Sinitsina. She is certainly not as titled, but no less scandals are associated with her. Let's see how such role goes to Julia. Apparently, Vera Birikova pulls up all her titled friends to TikTok house, so it will soon become a gymnastics house. Meanwhile, the international tournament for the prizes of the Olympic champion Marina Lobach has started in Minsk. It was the tournament to which the teams of Russia and Ukraine were supposed to come. I spoke about the reasons for their non-arrival in the previous video. However, gymnasts from Israel, Armenia and Lithuania came to the tournament. Of the minuses, not all the first numbers of the national team arrived, but all of the advantages is that at least someone came and it became a real international tournament. Anastasia Salas and Alina Gardnesko, the best gymnast of the Belarusian national team, performed at the tournament. I think this sports season they appear most often in tournaments. Great respect to them for that. The tournament even has a live stream, so it would be great if more countries participated in the tournament. By the way, the girls got quite high marks here, but I think everyone is used to the fact that at home championships, the scores are much higher than at major starts. It was especially interesting for me to see the performances of Noga Block, a gymnast who recently performed in juniors and just switched to the senior program. And in fact, a gymnast who in the near future will replace Israeli leaders Linoa Shram and Nicole Zeligman. I like the performances, her legs, everything in the tradition of Israel, unusual dance floors and interesting work with the apparatus. True, it is still noticeable that Block is not so experienced and looks still very young. It will be interesting to watch how she grows up and changes, but overall, she's a very pleasant girl. Alina Gardnesko and Anastasia Salas are traditionally in good shape, and I think it is noticeable how they add in performance and confidence from start to start. I admit mistakes of the girls, but despite this, it is a pleasure to follow them. Despite the fact that I said about the estimates, the height still surprised me. So Alina Gardnesko scored 27.8 for the ball. And for the clubs, Alina received as much as 28.4. On the first day, the girls competed for the medals of the all-around, and on November 8th, the medals of the finals will be played. But let's talk about who won what on the first day. For which I love such tournaments is for very interesting awards, and the fact that I award many girls regardless of their performances. So there were many nominations at the tournament. For instance, Daria Strelcova won the Audience Award, Elizaveta Zorkina Smile Prize, Daria Tkachova Grace Prize, Sakhar Libovich, Israeli gymnast, was awarded for elegance, Anastasia Salas received the Inspiration Prize, Blog Noga Prize for the Will to Win, Dina Agishova received a nomination for originality, and Alina Gardnesko won the Miss of the Tournament. According to the results of the tournament among juniors, the first place was taken by Dina Agishova, the second place by Elizaveta Zorkina, and the third place by Polina Slachievskaya. Alina Gardnesko won the all-around for seniors, Anastasia Silos won silver and Anna Kamichikova took bronze. Meanwhile, Katya Galkina is posting a story from the hospital again. Apparently, the treatment continues and Katya has not yet returned to trainings. Evgenia Levanova also posted photos and stories on her Instagram from hospital, where she thanks everybody for their support and wrote that everything is fine with her. Apparently, even the absence of competition and quarantine still brings injuries to athletes, or it is just an excuse to heal the injury. The question with which at the latest are simply overwhelmed: what is happening to Sasha Soldatova? Will she come back? Did she end her career? And what happens to her? Well, let's speculate a little. Recently, this question was asked to Irina Alexandrovna, and she replied that now Sasha is on the path for recovery. She conducts master classes. According to Irina Viner, if Sasha Soldatova wants to decide to return, she will gladly help her. And what do we see in fact? Sasha actively maintains her social networks, so shows how she develops and learns new things, shows how she prepares food, meets with friends, and visits her coach. From Sasha workouts, you can occasionally see the gym and more often the training format, which was quarantine. From this, I think we can conclude that Sasha is not fully training. However, she does not speak about the end of her career and constantly throws information that we will see her again and that she has not finished with sports. I think we can only wait, because the words and what we see are clearly not consistent with each other. Judging by Instagram, I would definitely say that Sasha will not return, especially remembering her interview, where she said that when she trained in Novogorsk, she spent all her time in gym. Now we don't see this, but the fans and fans can only hope that Sasha will finish the restoration and appear at least at the demonstration performances. By tradition, I'm waiting for your comments and suggestions. What do you think, whether Sasha will come back to the carpet and try to compete with the current stars, or she will not pull in health and emotional state? As always, I want to believe in the best, and I recall the example of Julia Bravikova, when a gymnast after a long break shone on the carpet. But I think many already have the feeling that Sasha will no longer perform in the framework of the competition, and simply will not pull competitions from juniors who are now running out of acting leaders. Well, that's it for today. Remember that I love you all and see you really soon. The video was translated and dubbed by Alexandra Sinitsina.